long time. My best wishes to you and to your parents. My namaskarams to all your parents. And let us have a small discussion about the family, our family. You are not talking about my family. My family means your family, our family. So the discussion is going on in the subject called science. Okay, whatever may be the subject, but family is a very essential thing. So my dear friends, small friends, I don't know what is the height that you improved in this holidays time. I'll be very happy to see you all. So my dear friends, in the family, I would like to ask you some questions. In a family, how many members are there in your family? Your mother is there, your father is there, your grandparents are there. In some cases, your uncle may be there, your aunt may be there, your brothers are there, or your sisters may be there. In some cases, your cousins may be there. Different families have different number of people in your family. So, take a family photo. Try to take a family photo. In your family photo, try to tell what is your mother's name, what is your father's name, what is your name, what is how many siblings you have. Try to give the answers to all these questions to your mother or your father. And how many cousins are there for you? Your parents are called grandparents. What is the name of your grandfather? What's the name of your grandmother? Your father's mother is here, your mother's mother and father. So you are having grandparents for both on either side, for father's side and also for mother's side. So try to note their names. What's your grandmother's name, grandfather's name? And your auntie's name, your uncle's names, and your cousin's name, their children, we call them as your cousins. Mostly, try to take the photo of your family and try to give the names of all these members in your family. And in what way your mother is helping you? Your mother is helping you. See, in a family, you're very safe in a family. You're very safe in your family. Your family is safeguarding you, caring you, giving you the clothing, giving you the required food, giving you the required shelter, protecting you. When you're not feeling well, all the members of the family are taking care of you. So in that way, when you're feeling hungry, your mother is giving food for you. She's taking care for you. So in that way, the family is a group where you get a lot of protection, a lot of care, a lot of happiness. You all share some stories. Your grandmother tells some stories to you. Your grandfather gives some toys for you. You play with the toys with your brothers and sisters and cousin brothers and cousin sisters. It is very difficult in absence of a family. See, in some cases, some children are orphans are there, where they miss the family members. It's very difficult. Their life is very difficult. So we have to thank God for giving a good family for us. And in a family, there's a great love and affection between all the members in a family. Your mother likes you. Your father loves you. Your brothers and sisters, they all like you. There's a great love and affection. People love you. So you must give respect for your mother. You must give respect to your father. You must give respect to all the members in your family. You must listen to your mother. You must listen to your father. Whatever the father and mother gives the instructions, children must listen. This is a very important habit. Listening is a very important habit in a family. You are the young, you may be small. They are more experienced. They are telling something to you. You must listen. These are all the things that you must maintain. So, my dear friends, there are many people in the family. So, I request all of you, have a notebook and a pen. I know that after a long time you may be writing, but writing. Please try to develop the skill of writing with the help of your mother and father are there who are supporting to you at home. Please write down the list of all these words: family, people, relation, mother, father, brother, sister, grandparents, uncle, aunt, children, cousin, respect, listening, worship. So we have to worship our parents. These are the hard words. I request you to please write these hard words. We must worship our parents. We must worship our parents. We must put the two hands together and we have to worship our parents. See, they are the people who are taking care of you all 24 hours time, all 7 days in a week, all 365 days in a year. From the time you are born, you are helpless, to the time you are very well grown, your parents are taking care of you, giving you best food possible, giving you best clothing possible, giving you best comforts possible. It is your respect to worship the parents. Worshipping the parents is our culture. In our culture, Matru Devo Bhava, Pitru Devo Bhava, Acharya Devo Bhava. See, mother is taking the first place. Father is taking the second place. Before the teacher. So I request all the children, please listen to your parents. Please try to follow the instructions given by them. Give respect to them. Be obedient to the elders. Thank you for listening to my class. Thank you.